Good evening everyone. So today we are going to learn how to write analytical paragraph. Yes. Now first of all, let's understand what is an analytical paragraph and on what basis is it written. Analytical paragraphs are written to analyze the data, the chart, the graph, the outline or clues which are given to us. They describe the facts in the best possible way. Now, we need to understand first of all the language which we need to use while writing an analytical paragraph. So we must remember that the language needs to be crisp, it needs to be clear. And it is written in how many words? 100 to 120 words. Second, now let's talk about the features of an analytical paragraph. So an analytical paragraph, it describes the given chart, table, data. You can be given an outline, some clues or a pie chart. So you have to describe it. Now we are going to talk about the format of an analytical paragraph. It includes three things: introduction, body, and then comes the conclusion. Yes. So we are going to understand these three things one by one. And yes, at the end of the video, I am even going to share a sample, a written sample of an analytical paragraph so that you all can understand and analyze the way it is to be written. So let's move ahead and talk about introduction. What should be the introduction of an analytical paragraph? It should describe the paragraph in brief. That is, you're going to introduce the context, which will be your opening line. And do not forget that your opening lines, you know, they should not be more than one or two lines, because you have to restrict yourself to the given word limit, which is 100 to 120 words. So this is what forms the introduction of an analytical paragraph. Then next comes your body. Yes, we're talking about the body of the analytical paragraph. First and the foremost thing is choose significant details. Do not include everything in your paragraph. Choose significant details. Now you can even divide your analytical paragraph. That first is your introductory line, and then you can divide the body of the analytical paragraph into sub paragraphs also. There is no restriction on that. Now first thing is organizing your information. Now how to organize? We have to look for prominent differences. We have to look for the smallest or the largest data. We have to look for the similar aspects. Yes. And then we have to look for the aspects that have remained unchanged. That is the aspects which have been constant. Second thing, after organizing your data, you are going to compare the information. After comparing the information, then you are going to mentor the quantities. I'm going to mention the quantities, that is percentage, fraction, ratios. You can be using all these things to describe your analytical paragraph. Now this forms your body, which further talks about that, you know, when you are talking about quantities, you can mention the figures appropriately. Now comes your tense. Remember, focus on this point. Use the same tense throughout the paragraph. Now, when you are using the tense, preferably use the passive form of the verb. And remember, no personal observation or response should be provided. You have to look into the evidences. You have to support your sentences with the things, the data given in to you in the question, which can be in form of a table, it can be in form of a pie chart. You have to look into the information from that particular area. Do not add in any other information which is not given to you yourself, which will create problem. You know, it will be incorrect then. Now, after looking into this aspect, we should remember that we should be brief and comprehensive. That is, but at the same time, we have to include all the information. State facts provided by the chart. and necessary to make use of simple and accurate language. So I'm focusing on this point again and again, that language plays an important role here. Your tense needs to be correct, use passive form and use accurate language. Moving ahead, you know, in the further part of the video, I'll be sharing few phrases for introducing, for writing in the body and to conclude as well. But here we are focusing on the features which are to be, you know, which have to be there in our analytical paragraph. Now your sentences, when we are talking about the accurate language, then we are talking about the sentences as well, that your sentences should be connected to each other. Do not just, you know, end your sentence abruptly anywhere without, you know, ending it properly. And last but not the least is your conclusion. Yes, last but not the least is your conclusion. Now let's look at few phrases or opening lines. Now if you are right, when you're writing the introduction of your paragraph, you can begin by writing this. The chart given above, the line graph shows, the table illustrates. Then, after writing the introduction, now you have to describe the trends given in the paragraph. That is, you should be using such phrases. Pattern of growth. The pattern of the growth can be visualized through the data given in the graph. The rapidly doubled, skyrocketed, striking increase can be witnessed in the given figures. Peaked, soaring rates of the commodities since 1990 to 2010. Declined, plummeted, leveled off, stagnated. The rates have been fluctuating, starting to rise. A drop down can be easily seen through the given figures. Slightly increase, slightly decrease. So these are the describing trends. How to establish the relationship or contrast? Relationship between. Similarly in the year 1950, this was seen. In contrast with, in comparison to rice, wheat is used more. But in the opposite case, however, whereas, when it comes to youth, as opposed to, while, striking differences are being witnessed. Noticeable difference is being witnessed between, you know, in the usage of internet by the youth and the adults. So see, I'm connecting, I'm establishing relationship or contrast. Then comes our conclusion. See, always remember, when you are writing a paragraph or you're writing anything, body definitely plays a role because that is what you are going to talk about. But your introduction and your conclusion needs to be very catchy, needs to be appropriate. What attracts the reader is the introduction. You know, even when you pick up an article, if you don't like the introduction of the article or a story, let's say, you don't feel like continuing it further. So introduction and conclusion, though body is extremely important, but introduction and conclusion needs to be your catchy. And conclusion is which sums up what your paragraph is talking about. So these are the few of the phrases which you can be using while writing your analytical paragraph. And well, these phrases can be generally even used when you're writing any paragraph or, you know, you're writing an article or a report. You can be using them. Now, overall the result is, subsequently, in a nutshell, I can say this. For the chart given up, in short, striking changes are clearly visible through the given table, including and therefore. So now, kids, I am going to share a sample with you of analytical paragraph. Now, this is a question. In this question, the table shows details about the internet activities for six categories for different age groups. Write an analytical paragraph for the given table in around 100 to 120 words. So yes, remember to restrict yourself to the given word limit. Now this is the table. This side, it shows me the activities, which is good. Get news, online games, download, product research, buying a product and searching for people. And these are the values which have been given to me. Here it talks about the age, that is teens, 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s and 70 plus. So this is the age group, you can say, which has been given. How do I start writing it? So my introduction is, the given table suggests the internet activities of 7 age groups. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I've clubbed all of them together and I've written suggests of 7 age groups ranging from teens to those in their 70s for 6 kinds of activities. Now what does the table show me? The table shows that the younger generation is more interested in online games and news, while the older generation spends time on the internet and research. So see, I have used the words which I've shared earlier, like more interested, then I've also, you know, while. So these are the words which I am using when I'm raising my comparison. Now then, next, moving on, the next paragraph talks about, see, it is evident from the table that the teens mainly use the internet for games. See, I'm using the ratios as well, like I'm using the percentages here. News and downloads, and are interested in searching for people or friends or doing any product research. So I am also talking about giving the details from the table here. I'm justifying, see, you have to justify what you are saying. And from where are you going to get the evidence? Evidences you will get from the table itself. The middle age group. Now I'm talking to 20s to 60s. See, I am clubbing the age groups. I am not going to talk about each age group separately. That would make my analytical paragraph, you know, very long. Then I'll exceed the word limit. But I have to restrict myself. So what did I do here? I have clubbed the age groups. Now the middle age group, people in 20s to 60s, is highly interested in getting news, research products and buying products. The percentage ranging from 70 to 80%. The internet activity which gets the least time is searching for people. All the age groups spend less than 30% of their internet time on the same. The amount of the time spent on downloads decreases. See, I'm using these words which I've just shared with you. With age, and gets as low as 6% for people in 70s. So starting with the middle age group, comparing it with the people in 70s in the same paragraph itself. Now comes my conclusion, which is, overall, the table suggests that teenagers are more likely to spend time playing games and doing downloads. On the other side, older people are interested in researching and buying products. People spend least amount of time searching for other people. So remember to use these phrases. Club the, you know, like I have clubbed over here the age groups, and I'm comparing and contrasting it at the same time. So I hope, kids, you've been able to analyze the way I have just shared this analytical paragraph with you. It is important for us to understand the structure and to divide our paragraph, you know, our analytical paragraph as per the format which I had shared with you earlier. That is introduction, body and conclusion. So my introduction was, the given table suggests, this was my introduction. Then this, you know, first part was the introduction. This is my body, wherein I've given all the evidences justified, and my conclusion. So I hope, kids, you've understood the format, the way of writing an analytical paragraph. And I'm going to share an assignment with you, a question for practice. Please practice, you'll be able to clarify your doubts. And go through the video, you'll understand the procedure as well. So we meet in the next video with the next topic. So bye everyone, take care, stay safe, stay home.